Hello and welcome to the channel. I'm Alman and today I will review the third studio album by the rock band The Strokes. First impressions of Earth, requested by Panarts. He is a big fan of The Strokes. I am a fan as well of The Strokes. How do I say it like that? I don't know, you know what I mean. I'm a fan of The Strokes too, I cannot speak. And I like them. I think they're a good band. I don't think they're necessarily the greatest band ever or something, because they just make, you know, catchy, simple rock music. But, you know, it kind of depends what you're, you know, what you see in a rock band. If that is, you know, simple rock music, then The Strokes are right up there as one of the greats. But kind of depends what you want out of a band. But there you go. The Strokes, pretty unexplainable. They make catchy yet, you know, simplistic yet catchy rock music, which I don't really mind, to be honest. Like the first two albums, I like Angles too, their later album, that was pretty good too. However, I always was kind of iffy on their third album, this one, First Impression of Earth, because it's really long-winded, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, because, you know, I am sometimes a fan of good albums, but you know, it's more in an operatic kind of, you know, opera or really like concept album wise I'm a fan of those, like, you know, The Wall by Pink Floyd or Quadrophenia by The Who, albums like that, you know, or Tommy by The Who, one of the two albums that are long, but they have, you know, they have a reason to be long. They tell a story, they have a concept in them. They tell a concept, and there's a reason they're that long. But for some reason, the Strokes, you know, they had that perfect formula of 30-minute-esque rock albums that are just catchy, yeah, and fun, and just, you know, they're simple yet catchy and fun, you know. But they kind of throw that whole element out of the window with this album, which I'm kind of. I'm pretty doubtful about that decision, because they make the album twice as long as Room on Fire, almost 52 minutes. Room on Fire was 32 minutes, so it's 20 minutes longer, almost, like, that's almost half of Room on Fire right there, like, holy shit. So that was a pretty bad choice, I would say, or, you know, bad. It was just kind of a doubtful decision to be made, but there you go. The album did spawn some singles like Juice Box, Harder in a Cage, and You Only Live Once. You Only Live Once is definitely the best song on there, though. The just a really like catchy, you know, that is pretty good. I really like that opening track. It's just a pretty catchy track, you know, pretty typical straightforward Strokes. Juicebox is good too. Pretty chaotic track, not necessarily the biggest fan of this song, but it is still one of my favorite, because this album does really turn into mush eventually, so there's that. It's pretty chaotic, it's pretty hectic, but it keeps me awake, I guess, whereas the rest of the album just kind of like bores me with all the filler, so there you go. Harder in a Cage is next, and I believe I believe Juicebox was the one that was really crazy, and Harder in a Cage was the more the soft one, I believe. These are interchangeable, I think. They both have some really quiet, dense parts, but they also have a lot of like breakout, kind of like crazy parts. Kind of interchangeable for me. Good singles, but they kind of feel the same to me. They feel like two of the same singles, so I'm not sure what's up with that, but there's that. And after those first three singles, the album really turns to mush, I would say. Razor Blade is just kind of like, you know, it's just the same as the first three, but just not catchy. On the Other Side is forgettable. Vision of Division is good though. That was a really great track. Really love the riffs on that song. Really enjoyable. This is the last track that really kept me awake before I just fell asleep listening to this album. So Vision of Division is definitely my favorite song of the album. It is my favorite, even better than You Only Live Once, which is kind of a fuck all song right now, or, you know, a fuck all thing to say, you know. I'm not gonna say it, but you know what I mean. like the most dated, can you call it a meme? The most dated word ever, arguably, or the most dated sentence. You know where I'm going with this. But Vision of the Vision, definitely the best song on the album. I like the title too. It's kind of fuck all, but it's kind of cool. There's the Vision in there, so whatever. But yeah, after that point, Ask Me Anything is so dumb. 3 minutes of just Nick Valenzi is on here, who is, I believe, from Queens of the Stone Age. No. Who the fuck is Nick Valenzi? He did collaborate with Regina Spektor once. That's pretty interesting. That is just a Strokes member, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, all lyrics written by Julian Casablancas, except for Noted, and Nick Valenzi helped with Ask Me Anything. Yeah, Nick Valenzi is a Strokes member. You can tell that I'm not the most invested into the Strokes, but I do like them though, so there's that. I don't know the band members by name and shit like that, so there you go. But Ask Me Anything, kind of a fuck-all song. I don't know what exactly happened in the song again, but there were some really one-tone Julian Casablancas notes, and that was really fucking boring me. Electricity Scape, I don't even remember this song, just 3.5 minutes, boring-ass, generic song that just, you know, flew right over my head, so it's kind of fuck-all. Killing Lies, boring, Fear of Sleep. Yeah, I was definitely fucking sleeping when this song fucking hit. I can tell you that. 15 minutes. I wish this album was about 15 minutes shorter. That's about right. Eyes of the World. And it's not written as in eyes, but I-Z-E. What? Well, what does that word mean? I might be dumb, but what is that word? Eyes with I-Z-E. That might be a made-up word, that's why it sounds so delusional to me. Evening Sun is 3 minutes long. It's also written by Fabrizio Moretti. Yeah, that's also, who is that? That's the drummer, oh shit. Ringo wrote the song, holy shit. It's automatically the worst song of the album. Nah, I'm just kidding, it's just like the same, it's boring shit. And then we get Red Light, which was literally the same song. I just went to my playlist and then, you know, I clicked on something and I was like, I really want to listen to this now. And then just kind of like semi turned off the Strokes. And yeah, that's kind of it, honestly. Not that I hate the Strokes. I love, you know, of course I love it. Is This It? Yeah. This Is It. Is This It? Yeah. I love Is This It and Room on Fire. I love those albums, but. Red Light was so pointless to me. So this album overall, it's really filler. It's like the first side is decent, but then, you know, the centerpiece song, Ask Me Anything or Electricity Scape, are fuck all songs. So I would essentially just side this album into like favorite tracks, the first side, least favorite, the rest, you know, side two. So that's essentially my opinion on this album. I think the first side of this album is pretty decent, but the second side is not necessarily bad, but just fucking boring. So that essentially would, you know, I would essentially give this album a 5 because I like one side of the album and the other side I don't care for. But I don't think it's a bad side or something. Yeah, I don't think that side 2 is bad. I just think it's fucking boring and forgettable. So I would essentially, how do you fucking say this? I would bump the rating a little bit up because I didn't mind the second side, but I didn't like it like the first side. So I'm gonna give this album a 6 out of 10. I thought it was really boring, really just whatever. It really left me cold. So. I don't care. What do you think about this album? Like and subscribe to the channel for future live as well. Let me know what you think about it in the comments down below. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace.